manufacturing and farming being absolutely decimated right here in the United States of America, yet the markets barely blink. It's Wednesday, November 20th, 2019. Please make sure to share this video with everybody you know. Put it all over your social media. They're making it very difficult for videos like this to be found. And make sure that you're checking on a daily basis for updated new videos. A lot of people have written me telling me that they're not being notified when new videos drop. So make sure you're checking on a daily basis and make sure that you subscribe to this channel and give it a thumbs up. Today, I want to talk a little bit more about this continued manipulation that we are watching take place in these markets. Before we talk about that, I wanted to talk about a statement that Ray Dalio, the billionaire, head of Bridgewater and Associates, he made a statement in an interview a few days ago that I was watching. He said this, he said, look at history. When you have a large income and wealth gap with little opportunity mixed with an economic downturn, you have a dangerous set of circumstances. And I think that statement is 100% true. It's 100% accurate. And that statement is where we're at today here in America. And we're gonna see some very dangerous events unfold here in America. I want to go over some facts, and many of you already know this, but I want to reiterate this for people who don't know. And I know that a lot of you talk to people on a daily basis who think that you're out of your minds, that everything is fine, you're blowing this out of proportion, the economy's doing great, the media's telling me that, my government's telling me that, the Federal Reserve's telling me that. So what do you know that they don't? And I want to just go over some facts that is a direct indicator of what is really happening here in America. Most of you already know this. We know that the Federal Reserve is doing everything they can right now in its power to put off this recession that has already begun. They're doing everything to stop it, to slow it down, but it is too late. This recession has begun. 70% of Americans are struggling financially right here in the U.S. That's a fact. Consumer confidence is declining. We just witnessed the largest decline for the Bloomberg Consumer Comfort Index since 2008. Fact, 58 million jobs in the U.S. pay less than $793 a week. 50% of U.S. workers make less than $33,000 a year. Ask yourself, when you look at these numbers, how in the world is anybody buying houses, cars? How are people living day to day with these kind of numbers? How is this economy going to prosper? How is it going to function in the very near future when we're looking at statistics like this? Auto loan delinquencies are skyrocketing. We just witnessed the worst decline for U.S. industrial production since 2009. And remember, we haven't even hit the speed bump yet. We're in the good times, and look where we're at right now. The case index has fallen for the 11th month in a row. Estimated GDP growth for the fourth quarter of 2019 is now at 0.3%, just a little over 0.25%. Fed purchasing $60 billion in T-bills every month, but they don't want you to call it quantitative easing. But everybody out there knows this is quantitative easing. Repo market injections happening daily. Now we're running into issues with China talks with the phase one agreement. We have no deal, no agreement, and this is just phase one. Ask yourself, if we even came to an agreement with phase one, how long would it take to get an agreement with phase two? But right now, as I've said, and many of you have said the same thing, there will be no China-US deal in 2020, and there may be no deal, period. We have this impeachment circus that is absolutely out of control. It's not going away, doing a lot of damage to this country. But you throw in all this economic uncertainty, all this social disruption taking place, and then all this political disruption taking place with this impeachment that has done so much damage to this country, and it's continuing. We're running a $1 trillion-plus deficit, and it's growing. We're witnessing the retail apocalypse, and it's growing. We look at auto sales falling off of a cliff, real estate now slowing down, commercial real estate, malls, these retail strip centers shutting down by the boatloads. This is where we're at right now. You have entered a recession right now in 2019, yet your politicians, the media, your friends are not telling you the truth. The truth is we're in big trouble. The recession has begun, and you need to be preparing because this is nothing. This is just the beginning. Things are going to get extremely worse. I made a video yesterday on some of the things that I did and a friend of mine did yesterday. We took some time out of our work week to make some preparations. If you get a chance, watch that video. I put it up yesterday. It's very good. There were a few things that I wish I would have included, did not have the time. And it was this: we saw an enormous amount of homeless people yesterday in Riverside County. There was a small tent city on the freeway entrance when we were getting on the freeway to come back home, with tents popping up all over the place right off the freeway. And the farther down you went, there were more tents along the freeway. I never saw that before. And just in some of the areas we were at, there was just more homeless people walking around in cities that I've never seen people walking around homeless, at least not to this extent. But it was really shocking to see tents along the freeway. I've not seen that in these parts of Riverside County. I know that there's a lot of homeless out there, but small tent cities popping up right outside of retail shopping areas along the freeway. And it's just eye-opening, and it's telling me that there is something very wrong. We are witnessing a homeless epidemic happening literally everywhere. Everywhere I go, every county I'm in, I'm experiencing homeless people literally everywhere. And whether it's a nice area or not so nice area, they're everywhere. And we've got a real serious problem here that we're not addressing, that we're not dealing with. And it is a reflection of what is really happening in this economy. And as I've said many times, don't judge these people. The video I did a couple weeks ago in Slap City, yeah, there's a lot of people on drugs, there's a lot of people with mental disabilities, but there's also a lot of people who had some bad luck, who didn't make a couple paychecks and got kicked out of their apartment, lost their house, went through a divorce, had a medical issue, went broke, and now once the car's broken, they can't get to work, they're in big trouble. And there's too many people out there that judge these people, and they're the same people who are literally a flat tire away or one or two paychecks away from being in the same circumstance, from being homeless. You know, if you don't have family members or if you don't have a close-knit group of friends to fall back on, ask yourself, what would you do if you didn't make two paychecks? What would you do if that flat tire happened to you? Could you survive? So we shouldn't be judging anybody. We should be preparing so that we avoid that situation at all costs. CNBC News today, talking about retail earnings, the manufacturing gauge, and home sales that we will be seeing tomorrow. These numbers are going to be released tomorrow. Just to name a few, Macy's, Nordstrom's, and The Gap. We're going to see their third quarter earnings tomorrow. I believe they're going to be disappointing. We're going to see the manufacturing gauge. Look for this to be down, no brainer. And home sales, I think this will be somewhat flat. And you know, when we talk about home sales, when we look at these numbers of 70, 80% of Americans financially struggling, living paycheck to paycheck, half the country now making under $33,000, who is buying these houses? Are these private individuals? Are these consumers? Or are these hedge funds, are these financial institutions buying these homes? I'd like to know the breakdown of how many consumers are buying homes versus financial institutions buying homes, because the numbers just don't jive. There just seems to be too many people financially struggling in America to even support the housing numbers that we're seeing right now. Zero Hedge today, global market slide after China says it's ready for worst case scenario. 2 a.m. this morning, the Global Times editor, Hugh Ai-jin, I'm probably not pronouncing that right, stated China wants a deal, but it's prepared for the worst case scenario, a prolonged trade war. I say give China what they want. This is now the time to stand up to China for the theft of all of our intellectual property, for the massive millions of jobs that our politicians sold us out and sent over to China and Asia. This is the time for America to stand up, hold its ground, and start becoming self-sufficient, self-reliant, forcing itself now to maybe build and start manufacturing its own products so that we're not reliant on countries like China. They're wielding way too much authority, too much power. Look what they did with the NBA. Look what they're doing with Hollywood. They're dictating the rules, and Hollywood and the NBA are bowing down to them. Corporations are bowing down to them because they have the power, and they are abusing their authority. This is a communist regime. Do not forget that. China is no friend of America. This is now the time to give them what they want. This is the time to step up. And yeah, there may be some pain here in America because it's a trade war. It's a war. It's called a war for a reason. There are sacrifices to be made. But if we don't do it now, we're never going to do it. And China will be the most powerful country, the most powerful military, and the most powerful economy in the entire world if we do not stand up to this regime right now. U.S. relations with China were just destroyed. That's also on Zero Hedge. The U.S. Senate just passed the Hong Kong Human Rights and Democracy Act of 2019. I mean, take a look at what is happening in Hong Kong right now. If you want to talk about an abuse of Chinese power, look at what's happening in Hong Kong. This has upset the Chinese. They're very angry with this act of 2019. The Chinese have been accusing the U.S. of being behind the protests in Hong Kong. And that may be true, it may be false. But true or not, the U.S. has sided with the protesters in Hong Kong by passing this bill. And I support the protesters 100%. Also, I support their fight for democracy, unlike the NBA. But this puts the trade deal on very, very shaky ground. It was on very shaky ground before this, but it's even shakier now. Basically, we are at a stalemate here. This president can raise tariffs. I don't think China is going to blink. I don't think China cares. There's going to be no deal in 2020, and it's very unlikely that we even see a deal in 2020. And I've always said, if we do get a phase one deal, it's going to be pretty much worthless anyways. We're going on about 25, 26 months right now with this deal, and we have got no agreement in phase one, and we're not even close to phase two. Just think of how long phase two could take. We could be dealing with China for years. This is the time for America to stand up and start becoming self-reliant, stop supporting slave labor, and stop supporting this communist regime. We're making them way too powerful and way too rich. What's interesting, while we look at all these economic numbers, we look at this trade war, Dow Jones today only down 112 points. And this is with all the bad data, all the negative news, all this idiotic impeachment that we're watching take place, and the phase one deal falling apart, all this. So we've got the impeachment circus, phase one falling apart. We look at all this economic data, it's all negative. We're looking at the numbers yesterday. Home Depot slammed, Kohl's decimated, Bed Bath & Beyond decimated, and a list of retailers who just third quarter earnings were just destroyed. It doesn't even faze the markets any longer. They're not even fazed by the China trade talks any longer. I mean, everything that we just discussed over the last 10, 12 minutes here, this market should be down 1,000 points. But this is just telling you how fake these markets are, that it's all an illusion, it's all being propped up, and this should really wake up every one of you, because you have to ask yourself, how much longer can this go on? It can go on for a little bit longer, but sooner or later, these markets are going to lose faith in the Fed, and people are going to lose faith in the markets, and people are going to lose faith in the politicians as we see this complete lawlessness taking place in Washington. And when things get out of control, it's going to happen quickly. It took a long time to get the Dow Jones over 28,000, and we're hovering a little bit under that right now. It took a long time to get there, but it is not going to take a long time to see the Dow Jones cut in half or even worse. When this thing falls, it's going to fall like a bowling ball out of an airplane 20,000 feet in the air. It's going to happen really, really fast. More than 450,000 people impacted by power blackout in California. So we've had winds the last couple days. We're having winds today. So PG&E has now cut power to about 180,000 people, but 450,000 people may be impacted by this. So here we are in California. Whenever we have fires or whenever we have windstorms now, there are certain areas of this state that now turn into third world countries where you have no power, no lights. You literally are now a third world country because of wind. And so another reminder of why you must take the time to prepare. Look, it's not all about gold and silver. It's not all about security. Make sure you have food. Make sure you have water. Make sure you have a trauma kit. Make sure you have the necessary pharmaceuticals that you need, maybe vitamins, things like that, because nothing bad's happened yet. But look at the warning signs. 500,000 people almost are going to be impacted by just some wind. And it just is another reminder of how quick they can flip a switch and all the power's gone. The water can get shut off. It's just all gone. And so what if there's a cyber attack? What if your grid goes down? Are you prepared to last 30 to 60 days or beyond? And remember, when people get hungry, when those plastic cars don't work and people don't get their EBT or their government subsidies, what do you think they're going to do? They're coming to your house, because they're going to think you have food or you have more than them. So we really have to really get in that mental mindset and think about what can happen and how quickly it can happen. So I'm going to wrap it up right here. But one last article, this was on CNBC News, Levi Strauss on taking big risk with an iconic jeans brand. They believe, Levi Jeans believes that they know more than you do. They want to get more involved with social issues right here in America. Now, they only make 1% of their jeans here in America. 99% of their jeans are made in other countries, mainly China. Now, I wonder how involved they are with social causes in China. I wonder what their interpretation or their beliefs are with Hong Kong. I wonder why they're not speaking about Hong Kong, but they're worried about guns in America. They don't make jeans here. They make them in other countries, mainly China, but they believe that we even care about what they think about social causes here in America. Think about that. Their stock was down 3.76% today, by the way. They should probably worry about more about how they're running their business than our gun rights here in America. I certainly don't need a jeans company or a fashion designer to tell me about my gun rights, certainly infringing on them. But again, ask yourself, are they speaking out about Hong Kong? Are they speaking out about social causes in China? You know the answer to that. But they believe they can come over here after they sold us out and took all those American jobs and brought them over to China so they could use that slave labor and get more wealthy, make bigger profits, and charge you more for the same pair of jeans while taking all those jobs out of America and sending them to places like China. This is the audacity of corporate America today and these kind of companies telling us that we shouldn't have the right to defend ourselves, we shouldn't own a firearm, you should listen to us, we know more about you and the social causes in America, even though we employ about 10 people in America and we sold you out and moved to China. I could care less what Levi Strauss thinks. I will never buy a pair of Levi Strauss jeans, and you shouldn't either. This is where we really have to think about where we're spending our money. What movies we're going to, are we supporting Hollywood? Are we supporting the NFL? Are we supporting athletic teams that disrespect the flag, the military, the police, and you and I, the American people? Do these people deserve our money? Places like Starbucks, do they deserve your $5 or $7 for a cup of coffee? Levi Strauss does not. Remember, they're going to take some of that money and they're going to use it against you, against your rights. So do not buy anything from Levi Strauss because you're supporting the enemy. I'm going to leave it there. Have an incredible day. Really think about the data points I gave you when people tell you how great the economy is. Ask them why, because I probably gave you at least 10 reasons why it's not. And if you think the economy's booming, please comment down below and tell me why you think it's booming. I'm definitely willing to listen. But for every one reason it's booming, there's about 20 that it's not. And I believe we're going to get some more bad economic data tomorrow when these markets open up and we see how some more of these retailers are doing, how manufacturing is doing. I think we're going to get some bad numbers tomorrow. Yet, it probably won't even affect the markets. The Dow will probably go up. So bad news is now good news. It seems like these markets now don't even care about China. They just continue to surge on. And so again, with all this bad news, Dow Jones only down 112 points today. Figure it out. I mean, what do you think? Please comment down below. Does it shock you that we were only down 112 points today with all the news that we got yesterday? All the economic data that we've been getting over the last couple weeks, and phase one now is literally over. It's not going to happen. We are not going to have a deal for 2020, and we are getting farther and farther apart with a deal with China. Please comment down below. Why do you think the markets are not being affected by this? I'd like to know your answer to this. Have a wonderful day. God bless every one of you. Make sure you share this video and make sure that you're praying for this country and make sure you're preparing. Big events are coming to America.